It is possible to become free from debt, financial worry, your boss, and your zip code. You can start living a life you love, but first, you need to find your freedom. Using financial independence and lifestyle design principles, you can create the life of your dreams now. There are many paths to freedom, and that is what this podcast is all about. My name is Becky from 20free.co, and I am the host of the Find Your Freedom podcast. Today, I'm going to cover what lifestyle design is, and we are going to go through an exercise to help you chart your path to your ideal lifestyle. Lifestyle design is intentionally creating a set of circumstances that allow you to live the way you want to, in full alignment with your values and priorities. Imagine you wake up without an alarm, to soft sunlight and the sound of waves crashing on the beach. You prepare your favorite cup of fragrant tea and stroll along the sand, sipping and feeling the sunshine warm your skin. After your walk, you spend some time preparing a delicious breakfast and practicing your preferred form of exercise. You take a dip in the warm, clear ocean and then sit at a desk in front of a window overlooking the sea for 2 hours to work. You're on no one's schedule but your own, and it feels so good. After a brief siesta and lunch, you do another hour or two of work and then meet up with some friends for a trip to the market and some exploration of the island. After an adventure and some local delicacies, you sit around a bonfire with a cold drink and some lighthearted conversation. Tomorrow, you'll get to do this again. You'll get to do this for the rest of your life, if you so choose. Do you think I was describing a wonderful work-related trip, or a slightly work-centric vacation, where you only have to work a few hours a day and can spend the rest of your time sleeping in, walking on the beach, touring your tropical paradise, and spending quality time with friends? Could you imagine this being your lifestyle permanently? I'd be willing to bet that your answer to the latter question would be no. You may be thinking that it sounds wonderful, but it's not realistic, at least not now. Maybe in retirement, but not when you're in your 20s, fresh out of college and just beginning a 45-year career. Let me ask you this. Why trade the best years of your life working for a company or corporation that in all likelihood does not care at all about you or your aspirations for 20 years of doing whatever you want, wherever you want, also known as traditional retirement, once you're past your prime and likely too old to pursue the passions of your younger self? Doesn't that seem massively backwards? Isn't there something in the pit of your stomach right now that is telling you that the work for 40 to 45 years and retire at 65 system is a waste of the prime years of your life? You probably don't want to do it, but you feel like you have to, right? Well, I'm here to tell you that you don't have to defer the gratification of pursuing your ideal lifestyle until you're retired. You can live the life that you've always dreamed about now. How? Well, this is where lifestyle design comes in. This concept became a part of my vocabulary when I was 14 and I read The 4-Hour Workweek, Escape 9-to-5, Live Anywhere, and Join the New Rich by Timothy Ferriss. It took me years to fully embrace this lifestyle design mindset, but I wouldn't be where I am today without reading this book. It was truly a crucial turning point in my path to freedom and redefining my life. In the book, which I would highly recommend to everyone, he puts forth a definition of both the term and the people who pursue it. The new rich are those who abandon the deferred life plan and create luxury lifestyles in the present, using the currency of the new rich, time and mobility. This is an art and a science we will refer to as lifestyle design. Lifestyle design is first about rejecting the status quo of waiting to live your ideal lifestyle until you're retired from a long career and accepting that you can live your ideal lifestyle now. Then it involves creating a luxury lifestyle, which frankly I find to be a bit of an unnecessarily frivolous term, but he's onto something. After all, the Merriam-Webster Dictionary describes luxury as a condition of abundance or great ease and comfort, which, if we're honest with ourselves, is something we all desire. I prefer the term ideal lifestyle, which connotes a condition of contentedness and comfort, but can be simple rather than extravagant. Everyone's ideal lifestyle is going to look different. That salt and sand island lifestyle that I described at the beginning of this episode is my ideal lifestyle. Others may choose to change the scenery to a cozy cabin on a mountainside with gorgeous sunset views, or an apartment in a city that's a mere minute's walk from any type of cuisine imaginable. There are those who enjoy the work that they do, and those who would love to escape the grind. Some want to travel, and others want to settle down and become a core part of their hometown community. Your ideal lifestyle might not look anything like mine, but the principles of applying lifestyle design are the same for you and me. The old currency that was used as a benchmark of wealth was cold, hard cash. With lifestyle design, the primary currencies that make you rich are time and mobility. You can live a rich life with little money, but a lot of free time to spend as you please. If you shed your obligation to be at a certain place at a certain time every day, also known as your job, for 40 to 60 hours a week, your flexibility will allow you to travel, visit with family, explore your passions, create change in the world, and enjoy more freedom every day. In short, lifestyle design is choosing how you live your life, rather than letting the American dream dictate how you're going to live it. When you choose to design your lifestyle, you are intentionally creating a set of circumstances that allow you to live the way you want to, now, rather than later. Regardless of what your ideal lifestyle looks like, you can achieve it. Like anything, this just takes dedication, focus, and a plan. The best time to start making this plan and putting it into action is now. Listen, I mean right now. Go grab a pen and paper or go to 20free.co/episode7 to get a free printable worksheet containing the lifestyle design exercise we're about to do. I'll wait. This is where we get to the actionable part of the episode. I want this to be more than just a podcast for listening to, so I'm making it a do-cast, where you're getting information from the podcast that you can take action on to create real outcomes in your life. If you take the time to work through this exercise with me today, you're taking a powerful step in finding your freedom. Feel free to pause the episode at any point to give yourself a few minutes to ponder the answers to the following questions. Keeping in mind that lifestyle design centers around spending your time and money doing things that you value, first, we are going to dive into your values. What are your values and priorities in life? This can be a hard question to answer if you haven't spent much time thinking about it. Some questions that I find helpful are actually the same questions I ask my interview guests at the end of every interview. What would you do if you never had to work again? If you could retire right now? And what would you do if you could never retire? These questions are so helpful because almost all of us were raised in the traditional 9-to-5 till 65 mindset. So we have answers to the questions of what we want to do for work and what we want to do when we retire. Now we're going to take these answers and figure out how to integrate them into lifestyle design. Next, revisit the question of your values and priorities. Do you value spending time with the people you love, making meaningful contributions to the world, improving your health, learning and growing, exploring and adventuring? Now take a few minutes to daydream and ask yourself, what does your ideal lifestyle look like? To help you answer this question, think of who you want to spend your time with, where you want to be, and what you want to spend your time doing. Think back to the scene I described in the beginning of this episode. I was living at the beach and working a few hours a day and spending the rest of my time with my friends, traveling and adventuring. Your ideal lifestyle could look completely different. Make this your own. Then ask yourself, why do I want my life to look like this? What would be different about your life if you were living your ideal lifestyle? What things have you gained and what things have you let go of? In my example, I got rid of my alarm clock and my 40 plus hour work week and traded those in for waking up with the sun and working only a few hours a week. I gained much more time outside and let go of living in my cubicle or in front of my computer. Next, we get to the questions of when and how. These are tactical questions that are going to vary for everyone. The when and how of your ideal lifestyle coming fully to fruition is going to depend on financial and other factors. Take a listen to episode 5 to learn everything you need to know about financial independence. In a future episode, I will also be discussing how to find balance between pursuing financial independence and lifestyle design. However, you do not need to wait until you have enough money to retire fully to start living your ideal life. There is a danger to putting off your ideal lifestyle in order to more intensely pursue financial independence. What you want now might not be what you want in the future. Tomorrow isn't promised to us or anyone we love. Time is a non-renewable resource. You and your kids, if you have them, are only this age once. The good news is, throughout the many stages of financial independence, you can start living your ideal life. You can actually start including components of it today. If you want more time with your family or friends, figure out what you can do to spend less time at work, move closer to where they live, or schedule more frequent get-togethers. If you want more freedom from obligations and responsibilities, see where you can start saying no in your life in order to say yes to those things that truly matter. I would recommend that you read two books to get more clarity on this idea: Essentialism by Greg McKeown and The One Thing by Gary Keller. If you want to live somewhere different, start looking for properties or rentals. Consider creative ways of affording to live this ideal lifestyle in your current financial situation, such as downsizing, living in a tiny house or RV, or moving to a less expensive area or even country to take advantage of geo-arbitrage. Then, think through the larger changes that need to happen for you to turn your ideal lifestyle into a reality. These changes are often changes in mindset, location, responsibilities, and finances. Some examples are selling your home and getting rid of your mortgage in order to have more mobility and less responsibility, quitting a job you hate and finding a dream job or starting your own business, outsourcing tasks you don't like doing to free up your time for things that are important to you. As we discussed, there are many ways you can start incorporating aspects of your ideal life now. There are also bigger decisions and changes that you have to make in the future to fully realize this ideal lifestyle. In the interim, you may want to consider doing a test run of this ideal lifestyle. These test runs can come in all shapes and sizes. There is part-time work, where you have time outside of work, maybe several days a week, to live your ideal life. Vacations, where you visit a place you might want to live, or rent an Airbnb and run through your ideal schedule for a short period of time. Sabbaticals, where you keep your job and might even get paid, but take time off. You can use this time to do a trial run of what your life would look like outside of your job. Mini retirements, where you leave or end your job and take time off in between to explore your ideal life. Remember, lifestyle design is intentionally creating a set of circumstances that allow you to live the way you want to, in full alignment with your values and priorities. This can mean selling everything you own, strapping a backpack to your back, and traveling the world as a digital nomad. Or it could mean prioritizing spending time with your loved ones over everything else, including work. Or it could mean finding ways to incorporate more of what you love into your current life, like spending time outdoors or learning new things. Ultimately, your lifestyle design is personal to you. To check out the show notes, which include links and resources mentioned in today's episode, go to 20free.co/episode7. That's the word 20, FREE.co/episode7. Do you need help figuring out what's next in your path to finding your freedom? Let's work together. As a money coach and lifestyle design expert, I am offering an exclusive small group coaching program this spring. As your coach, I will help you gain clarity about what freedom looks like for you, develop a strategy to get there, and overcome your money roadblocks on the path to financial and lifestyle freedom. People work with me because they want to start living their ideal life, but they don't have a clear path to get there. And they don't want to spend years or even decades using trial and error and disjointed advice from the internet to figure out how to make it happen. I offer both the proven tools that will clarify your vision and path, as well as intense accountability to make sure that you take the action needed to change your life. So if you want to take the concepts you are learning on this podcast and apply them to your life with my help, apply for the group coaching program now. Applications for limited available spots in the spring 2020 program are now open. Visit 20free.co/group coaching to apply today and schedule your free 10-minute call with me. I can't wait to help you transform your life and find your freedom. If you enjoyed today's episode, make sure you're subscribed to the Find Your Freedom podcast on whatever app you're using to listen to this episode. Do me a favor and also leave a rating and review on Apple Podcasts. Go to 20free.co/iTunes to be redirected to the page on Apple Podcasts where you can leave your rating and review. I really appreciate it. If you think this episode would help someone you know, please share it with a friend. Thank you so much for tuning in to this episode of the Find Your Freedom podcast. My name is Becky. You can connect with me on Instagram and Twitter at 20freeco and sign up for free resources and email updates at www.20free.co. That's the word 20, FREE.co. I'll talk to you next week on another episode of the Find Your Freedom podcast.